and then work it there.
So the girls, you have a little curve, okay, that gives you more room.
John, we saved a gap for you.
Thank you.
What music is being played?
I forgot to iron the pants.
I'm just sitting back here, making fun of everybody.
Words of wisdom.
Words of wisdom.
Getting married is a good idea.
It's a good idea. What about you?
Nice. Ditto. I mean, I don't know. Can't say for sure, but it sounds like a pretty good idea. A lot of married people I know are happy. So
I do have some words of wisdom. That don't kill me, can only make me stronger.
Amen. Amen.
Throw the weight. Oh, they'll be up there soon. Outside.
Yeah. I just remember. Yeah. I'm doing good.
We'll be circled around.
Good.
I'm excited.
Yeah.
L-O-V-E.
Just lean over?
Yeah. Your head is the middle one.
Wow.
Not be anxious about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, nor about your body.
In the same way, husbands should love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. For no one ever hated his own flesh, but nourishes and cherishes it, just as Christ does the church, because we are members of his body.
Paul tells husbands, love your wives as Christ loved the church. And then, in verses 26 and 27, he explains how Jesus loves the church. And then it says again in verse 28, in the same way that Jesus loves the church, husbands should love their wives. Nourish him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep only look to him as long as you both shall live. I now pronounce you man and wife. Please seal your marriage.
It only makes it worse to live.